Friends, I am Dr. S.K. Mittal. In this lecture, I have taken a problem which is based on Kirchhoff's current law equilibrium equations. This is the circuit diagram, and for this circuit diagram, first we have to draw the directed graph, then second F cut set matrix, then third part which we have to calculate is nodal or KCL equilibrium equations, then branch voltages and branch current. This is the circuit diagram, and for this circuit diagram, first part is the directed graph. To draw the directed graph from any given circuit, we have to note that all the current sources are open circuited and all the voltage sources from the circuit can be short circuited. This is the basic idea which we must follow before drawing the directed graph. See, this is the circuit diagram and this is the reference line. This reference line has four connections of 10 ampere, 5 mho, 5 mho and 10 ohm. Since this is a reference line and it is a conducting line, this can be considered at a point. Therefore, on the basis of this circuit diagram, we can draw this circuit diagram. Total reference line I have converted into one point. So this is the point which represents the reference line. And now, see, this is the current source, and this current source will be open circuited. Now see, for this circuit, if this is converted into a reference node, then this will be a junction, this will also be a junction, and this will be, this reference line will be a reference node or junction. Therefore, I have considered two junctions at upper side, A and B, and then C as the reference node. Now, there is a current source of 10 ampere. So now this is the current source of 10 ampere, and in parallel with 10 ohm, there is admittance or conductance of 5 mho. So this is the 5 mho. If I consider this at point A and this as point B, then between point A and B, there is 5 mho conductance. And then between A and B, there is 5 mho. And then between this reference and if this is B point, then between B and the reference, there will be two admittances, 5 ohm and 10 ohm. So now this is the simplified circuit diagram. And on the basis of this, we will draw the directed graph. So now for this circuit, first of all, we have to open circuit this current source. And now between A and C, in place of 5 ohm, there is branch 1. So now this 5 ohm will represent the branch 1. Between A and B, which is the 5 mho conductance, is represented by branch 2. Therefore, branch 2 of 5 mho is between A and B. This 5 mho between B and C is represented by branch number 3. This is the branch number 3, and this 10 mho will be represented by branch number 4. So this will be the branch number 4. Since in the circuit diagram direction is not given, therefore arbitrarily we can select the direction. So now if it is a branch 1, then we will consider in the circuit diagram direction of branch 1 is towards A. The direction of branch 2 between A and B, I will consider like this. Between B and C, for 5 moho, I will consider this direction, and for 10 moho, I will consider this direction. Now, by open circuiting this 10 ampere current source, this will be the oriented graph. So, this is the oriented graph. The first part we have completed, which was the oriented graph or directed graph. Now, on the basis of this directed graph, we have to draw the F cut set matrix, or we have to determine the F cut set matrix. So now, to determine F cut set matrix, first of all, from the given directed graph, we have to select one tree. Since this directed graph has three nodes A, B and C, therefore the tree must also have all the nodes A, B and C. And now, for nodes A and B and C, this will be the tree. We can select another tree also, but I have selected the tree which is consisting of branches 1 and 3. There may be several number of trees, but I have considered this. Since this tree, we can say this is the selected tree from this given directed graph. Now, if 1 and 3 are forming a tree, then twigs we can say will be 1 and 3. Twigs will be 1 and 3, and then other remaining branches which are 2 and 4 will be cards. Now, this is the selected tree, and for this selected tree, I have decided the twigs 1 and 3 and the cards which are not on the tree but which are present on the directed graph are 2 and 4. Now, after deciding twigs and cards, I have to determine F cut sets. So, now to determine the F cut sets, what we must do, we must remove tree branches or twigs one by one. Suppose I remove twig branch or tree branch one. Suppose I remove this branch, then there will be node A, and the third branch will be between and C will be remaining. Therefore, this A is known as isolated node, and the branch 3 between B and C will be a subgraph. Therefore, from here we have decided one isolated node, which is A. Now, after that, twig number 3 will be removed, and if 3 branch is removed from this tree, this 3 number branch is removed, then B will be isolated node, and a subgraph having branch 1 will be obtained. So now we have isolated node B and a subgraph consisting of 1. So now, from this analysis, we have decided two isolated nodes A and B. Therefore, two F cut sets will be formed at these isolated nodes. So now, see here, I want to make F cut sets. So now I have decided that isolated nodes A and B are isolated nodes. Therefore, at A, if I connect link number 2, then T branch 1 and 2 will form a F cut set, and this F cut set will be represented by tree branch number 1, and this tree branch and this F cut set, which is formed at isolated node, will be consisting of branches 1 and 2. Now the reference direction. We know that in case of F cut sets, the direction is the direction of twig at isolated node A. So now the direction of twig 1 towards isolated node is towards, therefore this is the reference direction. Now we have decided that other isolated node is B, therefore we will form another F cut set at isolated node B by connecting two cards 2 and 4 at B. So now the F cut set, other F cut set, which is named on the basis of twig number 3, will be F cut set 3, and this will be consisting of branches 2, 3 and 4. So now these are the branches which are under F cut set number 3, and the reference direction of this will be, see, the direction of twig from this isolated node, the direction of twig 3 is away, therefore reference will be away. So now on the basis of this, I have decided F cut set 1 and F cut set 3, means there are two F cut sets, because we know that number of F cut sets is equal to number of twigs. Now here, to form F cut set matrix which is represented by Q, what I have done, I have represented the number of rows. In case of F cut set matrix, number of rows is equal to number of F cut sets. There are two F cut sets, 1 and 3. So here I have written F cut set 1 and F cut set 3. Therefore, there will be two rows here in this F cut set matrix. Since the branches on this directed graph are 4, therefore the number of columns in this F cut set matrix will be 4, then 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are 4 columns in this. Now see, this F cut set 1. This F cut set 1 is having branches 1 and 2. Therefore 1 and 2 will be 1, and 3 and 4 will be considered 0. Now see the direction. The direction of twig number 1 and the reference are same. Therefore 1 will be positive. And see, the card number 2 is away from the isolated node, which is opposite of the reference. Therefore for branch number 2 I have written minus 1. So see, for F cut set number 3, for F cut set number 3, the associated branches are 2, 3, 4. Therefore, for 2, 3, 4, I have written 1, and for 1, I have written 0. Now, see the direction. The twig direction 3 is towards the reference, similar to reference. Therefore, branch number 3 will be with positive sign. Branch number 2 is towards the isolated node B, but reference is away. Therefore, 2 will be with negative sign. And now, 4 number branch or 4 number chord, which is away, means it is similar to the direction of reference. Therefore, it will be considered with positive 1. So now, this will be F cut set matrix, which is Q. Now, I have formed here or determined here F cut set matrix, which was the second part of this question. Now, after deciding F cut set matrix, we will decide nodal or KCL equilibrium equations. So see, this is known as network equilibrium equations on the Kirchhoff's current law basis or nodal basis. Q is the F cut set matrix, YB is the admittance matrix, and this is the Q transpose, means cut set matrix transpose. VT means it is the column matrix of the tree branch voltages. IS is the column matrix of current sources, whereas VS is the column matrix of source voltages. Now, on the basis of this, after forming the F cut set matrix Q, I will determine the network equilibrium equation. To determine the network equilibrium equation, this is the network equilibrium equation. This equation consists of Q, YB, VT, IS, VS. Therefore, first of all, before applying this formula, I will determine all the constraints of this equation. So, since I have already decided the F cut set matrix Q. So, this is the F cut set matrix Q. So, Q I have decided. Now, after that, see the circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram. Branch 1 is having 5 moho conductance or admittance. Branch 2 is having 5 moho. Branch 3 is having 5 moho. And branch 4 is having 10 moho conductance or admittance. And since there are 4 branches in this oriented graph, therefore there will be 4 admittances. Therefore, branch admittance matrix will be of size 4 by 4. Since branches 1, 2 and 3 are having 5 moho and branch 4 is having 10 moho, so I have written this is the admittance of first branch, second branch, third branch, and this is the admittance of fourth branch. So this is the branch admittance matrix. Now see, this is the selected tree, one of the selected tree from this oriented graph, which are having two branches 1 and 3. Therefore, the tree branch voltages are represented by VT1 and VT3. So here I have written the tree branch voltage VT. Since there are two twigs or two tree branches, therefore there will be a column matrix of two rows. Now see, this is the circuit diagram, and in this circuit diagram there is no voltage source. Therefore, VS matrix, which is a column matrix, will be zero. Now see the circuit diagram. This circuit diagram is having one current source, and this current source is parallel to branch 1. So now here the current source matrix will consist of 4 entries, and since current source is parallel to branch 1, therefore the 10 ampere current source value will be kept in row number 1. Since other branches are not having current sources, therefore all the remaining 3 entries will be 0. But what is the sign convention for this current source? See, here I have represented the sign convention. If see, this is the direction of current source and this is the direction of parallel branch, then in this case, in the matrix, if the current source value is I, then put minus I. See, this is the second sign convention, this is the direction of current source and this is the direction of twig. And if this is the direction of twig, then in the current source matrix put plus I. So see here, this is the direction of current source and this is the direction of branch number 1. So therefore, I will follow this sign convention, and therefore for this region I have here put minus 10. So since till now we have decided the F cut set matrix Q, branch admittance matrix YB, tree branch voltages VT1 and VT3, source voltage matrix and current source matrix, and this is the sign convention for the current source in the circuit diagram. Now after deciding all these matrices, what I will do, I will consider this equation to obtain the network equilibrium equation. See the left hand side of this network equilibrium equation on the KCL basis. This is Q, YB, Q transpose, VT. This is the Q matrix which I have obtained earlier. This is the branch admittance matrix YB and this is the transpose matrix of this. The first row I have converted into first column and this second row I have considered as the second column. And now this is the VT, where VT I have decided VT1 and VT3. Now we know that the matrix multiplication of Q, YB and Q transpose, then after multiplication of Q and YB, this is the result. This is the matrix multiplication of Q and YB. And then this is the Q transpose matrix. And if we multiply this QYB matrix multiply with Q transpose matrix, then the result is this matrix, which consists of 10, 5, 5, 20 in the row, and then VT1, VT3. This is the tree branch voltage. So I have decided the left hand side of network equilibrium equation. Now after that, I will decide the right hand side. The right hand side of this matrix, our network equilibrium equation, is Q IS minus YB into VS. Now see, I have written here Q matrix and then this is the IS matrix. Now here I have not written YB intentionally because VS matrix, because the matrix VS, all the entries are 0. Therefore, this multiplication of two matrices will be 0. Now, the remaining matrix will be Q matrix and I matrix. IS matrix. So, this is the simply Q matrix and this is the IS matrix. If we multiply this Q matrix and IS matrix, the result will be minus 10. 1 multiplied by minus 10 plus minus 1 multiplied by 0 plus 0 multiplied by 0 plus 0 multiplied by 0. So this will be the result of matrix Q and IS. So this is the right hand side of network equilibrium equation. So now here I have determined the left hand side of the network equilibrium equation on nodal basis. This is the left hand side of the network equilibrium equation and this is the right hand side of the network equilibrium equation. Now from this we can solve this by matrix method, as well as we can also solve by forming two equations. So now from here we can get ten VT one plus 5 VT 3 plus 5 VT 3, and in the first column of right hand side it is minus 10. Now the second row is 5, then 5 VT 1 plus 20 VT 3, 5 VT 1 plus 20 VT 3, and the right hand side of the column matrix is 0. Then these are the two equations which we obtain from this matrix, and from this matrix we obtain by solving these two equations or matrix, we can get the tree branch voltages VT1. The VT1 comes minus 8/7 volt, and the third branch voltage VT3 is equal to 2/7 volt. So now we have decided the tree branch voltages VT1 and VT3. After that, the last calculation is the calculation of branch voltages. This is the general equation which I have explained in previous video. This is the matrix of matrix to calculate the branch voltages. VB is equal to Q transpose VT plus VS. Since the circuit diagram is having, our oriented graph is having four branches, therefore there will be four branches or four branch voltages. So here VB, I have written V1, V2, V3 and V4 is equal to, since we have calculated the F cut set matrix Q, then here I have written the Q transpose matrix. And VT is nothing but VT1, VT3. And VT1 I have calculated here. The value of VT1 is minus 8/7 volt, and VT3 2/7 volt. So this is the VT1 minus 8/7 volt, and then VT3 2/7 volt. So here I have written the matrix VT, which consists of VT1 and VT3, plus this is the matrix VS. So now solving the Q transpose matrix and VT, means multiplying Q transpose matrix and VT and adding the voltage source matrix, we get four values: minus 8/7, 6/7, 2/7 and 2/7. This is the simple matrix multiplication. So now I have obtained VB is equal to this, where if I have written VB is equal to a matrix of minus 8/7, 6/7, 2/7, 2/7, then we can say that V1 is equal to, means first branch voltage is minus 8/7 volt, V2 second branch voltage, this is the second branch voltage, which is 6/7, the third branch voltage, which is having 5 mho conductance, is 2/7, and the fourth branch, which is consisting of 10 moho, is having the voltage of 2 by 7. Then after calculating the branch voltages, this is the formula to calculate the branch currents, which I have described in previous video. IB is equal to YB VB minus IS. IB is nothing but branch currents. Since the oriented graph and the circuit are having four branches, therefore I have written here IB is equal to I1, I2, I3 and I4. Here this is the branch admittance matrix YB, and VB I have determined here. This is the value of VB I have written here, and therefore minus IS, and the current source matrix already I have decided. So this is the IS matrix. This is the VB matrix which I have considered from here. So now if we multiply the two matrices YB and VB, and then if the result of this, and if multiplication of YB and VB, and then IS is subtracted from the result, then we can obtain the four currents I1, I2, I3, I4, where I1 is equal to 30 by 7, I2 is equal to 30 by 7, I3 is equal to 10 by 7, I4 is equal to 20 by 7. See here, I have not representing the multiplication due to lack of time. It is the simple matrix. These are the simple matrix multiplications. Here, then I have considered the branch currents I1, I2, I3 and I4. So these are the various branch current: I1 30 by 7 ampere, I2 30 by 7 ampere, I3 10 by 7 ampere, I4 20 by 7 ampere. So these are the branch currents, and these are the various branch voltages. So in this way, for the given circuit, we have to determine first of all the directed graph. So this is the directed graph, and for this directed graph I have obtained the second part, which is F cut set matrix. This is the F cut set matrix, and on the basis of these calculations, this is the network equilibrium equations on Kirchhoff's current law basis or nodal equation basis. And then for this I have calculated here all the, this is the branch admittance matrix, tree branch voltage matrix, source voltage matrix, IS, and then what I have done, simply I have calculated this equation, matrix equation, left hand side and right hand side, and then equated, and then after this I have obtained two values. I have equated here right left hand side. This is the left hand side, and after calculating left hand side I have calculated here right hand side, and then equation after equated, then I have obtained the tree branch voltages. After calculating the tree branch voltages, what I have done here, I have obtained the branch voltages VB. So this is the standard equation of branch voltage, Q transpose VT plus VS. Q matrix I have determined, VT is consisting of VT1 and VT3. Then I have multiplied here and get the V1, V2, V3, V4. Now this is the standard equation to calculate the branch currents. Then this is the YB matrix VB, and this is the minus sign. IS matrix. And then after solving, I have obtained I1 corresponding to 30 by 7 ampere, I2 30 by 7 ampere, I3 is equal to 10 by 7 ampere, I4 20 by 7. Then in this way, I have obtained the various answers. See, to obtain the to solve any question on Kirchhoff's current law based equilibrium equation or Kirchhoff's voltage law based equilibrium equation, the matrix multiplication and addition must be known very well. Thank you.